So in our next question, we have some given information and with the one diagram also. As you can see, we have to find A, B and C, and it is given that we have this angle 58 degree, and few more information is given in the question, such as AE is parallel to BD, AE is parallel to BD, this whole line is parallel, so I can write this thing in given, AE is parallel to BD. Second thing is AC parallel to ED. AC is parallel to ED. And AB equals to AC. AB equals to AC. These two sides are equal. And we need to find angle A, angle B and angle C. To find angle A, angle B, angle C. So, how to think is an important question, not how to do. So, whenever we have parallel lines, we should think along the lines of parallel line properties, such as corresponding angles, okay, alternate interior angles, and co-interior angles, and when we have some intersecting lines, as you can see they are intersecting, we should also think about vertically opposite angles. I have discussed these properties in earlier videos in great detail. If you want to see, you can watch that video also. I will share that link in the description box. For now, let's move on to our question. So, first thing is we should focus on what is given, and we should focus on related things. And whatever the value is given. See, 58 is given. With the help of this, I can find this angle. Can you guess by which property? Yes, vertically opposite angles. So I'm labeling it as angle 1. So solution, angle 1 equals to 58 degree. Straight away write vertically opposite angle property. Since this line is parallel to this, so angle 1 is equals to angle C. By which property? Can you guess? Yes, you're right. It's corresponding angle property. Well, on the same side of transversal, one inside, one outside. Same side of transversal, one inside, one outside. So angle 1 is equals to angle C. I can write corresponding angle property. So therefore angle C equals to 58 degree. So we are done with that. Now let's think about angle B and angle A. So some of you might think that B and C are co-interior since they are on the same side of transversal, but you forget that we only take these properties when they have parallel lines. As you can see, this line and this line is not parallel, so we cannot take co-interior angle property over here. So we have to move in this direction. Since this line is parallel to this, can I find this angle? Can you guess which property? If you change the orientation, it will look like this. Corresponding angle 1 equals to angle 2, corresponding angle property. So angle 2 equals to 58 degree. That's it. So one more information was given, AB equals to AC. So in a triangle, if two sides are equal, we already know that opposite angles are also equal by the property called isosceles triangle property. In triangle ABC, it is given that AB equals to AC, given, and we can write AB doesn't have C, angle C, opposite angle C equals to angle B. We can write isosceles triangle property. So we got this angle, angle B is also 58 degree. So we got this angle also 58 degree. So by angles and property, I can find angle A. Therefore, A plus angle B plus angle 2 equals to 180 degree by the property called angles and property. Angle A we have to find. Angle B we have already 58 degree plus 58 degree equals to 180 degree. Angle A equals to 180 minus 116. So angle A equals to 64 degree. So we got two things, one is angle C and one is angle A. So any guesses how to go about for angle B? Angle B is a bit tricky but nevertheless it's easy. As you can see, angle 2, can I find angle 3 also? See, it's cross, just like here, cross. By the alternate interior angle property, I can say these two angles are equal. So angle 2 equals to angle 3. Alternate interior angles. So angle 3 equals to 58 degree. That's also found. Now if we focus at the figure carefully, that this angle plus this angle plus this angle, it's forming a straight line. It's forming a 180 degree. So angle A plus angle 3 plus angle B is 180 degree by the property called straight angle property. Angle A plus angle 3 plus angle B equals to 180 degree. We can write straight angle. So angle A is what? So angle A is 64 degree, angle 3 is 58 degree, angle B we need to find. So angle B equals to 180 minus, it becomes 50 plus 60 is what, 110 and 120. Degree. So angle B is 58 degree. Hope you understand the question. So if you have any doubt, you can write in comment box, and see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.